Hello and welcome to the episode 135 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Among other things, today we're focusing on a bit of live action, a chance meeting that will change a lifetime and a lengthy interview. Let's begin with the first. On the 15th of May 1960, the Silver Beetles had their first and only performance at the Iron Door Club in Liverpool for a lunchtime concert. For the occasion, the band shared the stage with Cass and the Casanovas. The Beatles would actually perform again at the venue, but only after it changed its name into the Liverpool Jazz Society in 1961 and then the Storyville Jazz Club in 1962. In 1961, as usual, we find the Beatles, featuring Pete Best on drums, on the stage of the Top 10 Club in Hamburg, West Germany, for another residency night. Same story in 1962, with the same lineup, busy with a concert for their third Hamburg residency, this time at the Star Club. Another concert in 1963 with the Beatles, now with Ringo Starr on drums, playing at the Royalty Theatre in Chester. Beatles historian Mark Lewison gives us the repertoire for the night. Some of the Guy, Thank You Girl, Do You Want to Know a Secret, Please Please Me, You Really Got a Hold on Me, I Saw Her Standing There, and From Me to You. Some Other Guy and You Really Got a Hold on Me had been in the band's repertoire for a long time, but they hadn't been consigned to tape for neither the band's first LP, Please Please Me, nor for any single or B-side release, something that would be unusual for other bands at the time. Only You Really Got a Hold on Me would eventually be recorded for release for the lads' second album with the Beatles. In 1967, manager Brian Epstein hosts a dinner party to celebrate the completion of the Beatles' new album, Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. After the dinner, Paul McCartney and some friends went to the Bag of Nails nightclub to watch Georgie Frame and the Blue Flames perform live. At the club, he met with Linda Eastman, who was at the club with members of the Animals. Eastman was known in music circles as a freelancer photographer. Paul invited Linda and the Animals to the speakeasy, where they heard Procol Harum playing live. After that, he invited her at his place. According to Linda, she was impressed enough with his magrits to eventually go on and marry him in 1969, becoming much more than his wife until her death in 1998. On the 15th of May 1968, after being in the news with their announcement of the birth of Apple Corps, John Lennon and Paul McCartney flew back to London from New York City. Finally, in 1969, Glyn Johns was at the Olympic Sound Studios to work on the 8-track tapes of the Get Back project. Also on this date, Paul McCartney was in Liverpool, visiting his father with Linda. At some point, he gave an interview to a former Liverpool Institute friend, Roy Corlett, now working for BBC's local radio station Radio Merseyside. The interview was broadcast during Light and Local on the 16th of May, between 12:31 and 1 p.m, but you can listen to it following the link in the episode description below. It contains Paul's comments on the Beatles' work at the time, their business issues, Beatlemania, Magical Mystery Tour, and other things. This concludes this episode of What a Fab Day. You might recall that some of the episodes have been recorded with extra bits, producing a deluxe version of the podcast. I am now thinking to perhaps offer this in limited exclusive monthly installments using the non-fungible token technology. For those who wonder what the heck that is, there's a link in the description. You might know NFTs and the recent developments they ushered onto the digital art world, but you can use them to offer exclusive and limited editions of audio products too. It might be a good way to support me and to actually make a pretty penny on the side by doing it, should you want to resell the tokens. Anyhow, keep your eyes on www.simonmas.com/support for further announcements on this initiative and on other ways in which you can show me how fab you are by supporting my efforts to create more music-related content for you to enjoy. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.